morning, my darling children. Welcome to Hooked on Jesus Online. Before we begin, let's do a recap of the last lesson. The Israelites were not able to drink the water because it was bitter, and they grumbled and complained because it was bitter and they couldn't drink it. God told Moses to take a piece of wood and throw it in the water, and it became sweet, and they drank the sweet water. Today our lesson is from Exodus chapter 16, verses 1 to 36. Let's pray. Father God, I want to thank you and praise you for each and every child watching this video. I pray and ask, Father God, that you will bless them to know how awesome and wonderful you are, how you love to bless them and provide for them every day. And I pray and ask, Father God, that each one of them will learn to love you, trust you, and to thank you. I ask this in Jesus' most precious and lovely name. Amen. Today's lesson is about the Israelites. They have now come to the desert of Sin, and it's the 15th day of the second month after they had left Egypt. Can you guess what they were complaining and grumbling about this time? It's food. Yes, they were complaining. And they told Moses and Aaron, "We wish that the Lord killed us in Egypt. There we could at least sit down and eat meat and other food as much as we wanted. But you have brought us out into the desert to starve us to death." It's sad the Israelites forgot how God, in his mighty power, freed them from slavery of 430 years in Egypt. Oh, God heard them grumbling and complaining to Moses, and he told Moses and Aaron that now he is going to rain food for them. And I want you to watch this video, which will explain this lesson to us. We are not the maker of this video. The maker of this video has been linked to the description of this video. We thank them for this video as it enables our children to learn God's word.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Aunt Fernita, and I have a wonderful story for you called God Gives Manna. Today's memory verse is from Joel chapter 2, verse 26. It says, "You will have plenty to eat, and you will praise the name of the Lord." The message for today's story is we thank God for giving us good food. Where do you get your food? From a store? From an orchard or a field? God gave the Israelites some unusual food. When the Israelites had been traveling in the desert for several weeks, the food they had brought with them from Egypt was almost gone. There were no grocery stores in the desert. There were no fields or trees to get food from either. Instead of trusting God, the Israelites began complaining and grumbling. God knew that they were worried, and God knew that they were hungry too. He knew they needed healthy food to keep them strong. So God told Moses that he would send them bread from heaven that night. In the morning, thin, white flakes lay on the ground all over the camp. The Israelites had never seen anything like it. "What is it?" they said to one another. It's the food the Lord has given you to eat, said Moses. Taste and eat. This special food tasted like crackers and honey. The people called it manna, which means, what is it? Then Moses said, each morning you will find manna on the ground. Get up early and gather enough for the day, but do not keep any overnight. But some people didn't listen to Moses. They tried to save some manna for the next day. The next morning their manna was spoiled and it smelled really bad. Some people were lazy and did not gather enough for the whole day. But the hot sun melted the manna and those people went hungry until the next day. On Friday, Moses told the people to gather enough manna for 2 days because God would not send manna on Sabbath. But some people didn't listen to Moses. On the other nights, the manna had spoiled, so they thought it would spoil on Friday night too. But it didn't, and on Sabbath, no new manna appeared on the ground. By the end of the first week, everyone knew that they had to follow God's directions. As long as they gathered enough manna for the whole day every morning, they had enough to eat. And on every Friday, they had to gather enough for 2 days. When the Israelites followed God's directions, they had fresh food every day. God took care of their needs, and God takes care of our needs too. God gives us our food today. He may not send manna from heaven, but however you get food, it is because God provides for your needs. Let's praise God for our food.
This podcast was brought to you by gracelink.net and Studio El Piso. For more children's resources, please visit gracelink.net.
Did you see how God provided food for the Israelites? He heard them complaining and said, I will rain down bread from heaven. And he instructs Moses to inform the people to gather enough bread for the day. And there were some people who disobeyed Moses and collected more and kept it for the next day. Moses was angry because the next day, that bread had gone bad and it smelled. Moses said, you have to take bread for each day. And there were some people who didn't trust God. Now, only on the sixth day, they had to collect bread for 2 days because the seventh day was a day of rest, the Sabbath day. So Moses told the people to collect bread for 2 days. And there were some people who disobeyed Moses and went out on the seventh day to collect bread. And there was no bread. And God was angry with them for disobeying him. The people of Israel called the bread manna. And for 40 years, God provided them every morning with bread and in the evening with meat. And they had sufficient till they reached Canaan, where they settled. God also provides food for us, and may we always be grateful and thank Him and trust Him and not grumble and complain. Our memory verse today is from John chapter 6, verse 33. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. In our lesson today, we see how God provided bread, manna, every morning for the Israelites for 40 years. In our memory verse, we see Jesus is the bread of God who came from heaven to die on the cross and take this punishment for your sins, my sins, and the sins of all the people in the world. His death and His resurrection gives us life. And when we believe and trust Him as our Lord and Savior, yes, children, how blessed we are to receive His love and His provision every day in our life. Amen. Now, Carolyn is going to show you some lovely craft. Enjoy. Bye.
Hey, hello, my children. Today we are going to learn a very different thing called as triorama. Triorama, yes, it sounds like a triangle, right? Yes, because it even looks like a triangle. I'm going to show you how to make it. It is very, very simple. So first, I'm going to show this on a rough white page, paper, which is an A4 size paper. Okay, but this is a rough thing that I'm going to show you, because the fair one I'm going to make out of a big card sheet. Okay, a big card sheet, which will not fit on in the camera. That's why I'm going to show you on a small A4 size paper. Alright, so it's very simple. Let's get started. So we are going to make a scene in the triorama. So for that, let us first try to make a square. So first we are going to align these two sides. Okay, and then we are going to cut on this side. We are going to cut it on this side, so we get a nice square. So here we have a square. I've cut it. Okay, here we have a square. Now let's make, now this is one fold. Now let's make another fold. Okay, that is the other side. There it goes. I'm going to join these two ends. Yes, and let's press it down. All right, now what we are going to do is, on any one of the folds, let's take this fold, any one of the folds, okay, it can be any one fold, we are going to cut. All right, so we are only going to cut till the center. Okay, only till the center. All right, don't go ahead of it. This is how we are going to do it. And till the center, and we are done. See, I've cut it only till the center. Okay, only till the center. All right, children, this side will be our scenery. Now we are going to do what? We are going to do the wilderness. Okay, where Moses took the Israelites, yes, through the wilderness. And our story is about how God provided food to the Israelites in the wilderness. That, what was the food? The quail for meat and the manna as bread. Okay, so we are going to make a scene, like we are going to draw mountains on this side. All right, and a sun and the quail, the bird, that is what we are going to draw here on this side. See where there is a cut, right? On this side we are going to write some stuff, or we're going to stick some things. And you know, this side is going to be where we are going to stick this part, like this. Okay, isn't it simple? Let me just show you with a piece of with a pencil or a marker. I will show you how it happens. Okay, so this side of the triangle will be the place where you will make your scenery. Okay, like whatever scenery you want to make, that is going to be on this side above the cut. This is the place where you can stick your things. This is the place where you can stick your things, and this you cannot do anything over here. Okay, this side You cannot do anything. Why? Because we are going to glue it like this. Okay? Alright, children. So first, let me glue and show you. So when we are making the triorama, you have to first finish doing everything on this side of the bigger triangle. Then only then you will start sticking. So let me quickly stick and show you the triorama. Now see children, I have glued this part. I have applied glue here. Now we'll pick up this flap where we have written stick, and we will nicely align it to the point here. Okay. And then let's press it down. Okay. When you press it down, see, this is what you get. So you get a nice triangle, but you can stick your stuff here, make it stand here. So it will look like there is a background scenery and in front there are things popping up. Okay. So this is called a triorama. All right, children. Now let's do the real one. Okay. So now, as I showed you on a rough page how to do a triorama, I have done the same procedure for a bigger paper. Okay, this whole paper is not fitting in, but I have done the same procedure. Okay, I've put the folds and I've put the cut. Alright, now before sticking it, we have to just do our painting. We have to finish our painting. Okay, so what for our topic, the manna and the quail that God fed the Israelites in the wilderness, for that we need to show a scene of the desert, of the wilderness, where the quail and the manna God is sending from above. We have to show that desert scene. Okay, so first I'm going to start with painting this part sky blue for the sky. All right so I'll be back, because this is a huge area to color. So I'll be back, I'll just paint this sky blue and I'll be back. All right, now I have painted the whole background sky blue. Okay, now on this I'm going to draw some mountains, and then we'll color those mountains brown. Okay, so let's start right from this end. Can you see this end? I will try. I think now you can see this end. Yes. Okay, so just start right from the corner. Okay, just to make a mountain anyhow. You can make the mountain anyhow. Those mountains don't need to be very perfect. You can have the mountains anyhow. Okay, that way. Now I didn't finish it here because I'm going to color this whole thing brown. All right, now let's color the mountains brown and I'll be back. Whoosh, I'm done with a lot of painting of the mountains and the sand on this side. Okay, on this side, you remember I told you this side we are going to keep plain. We are not going to do anything because this is going to go under. We're going to stick it like this, correct? Yes. So I'm not going to do anything here. Okay, and my mountains are done. Now let's make a sun and some birds. For birds, I'm going to do very simple. I'm just going to dip my brush in black color. Alright, here I go. And we are just going to make small R's and big R's. We are just going to make small R's and big R's, small R's and big R's. That's it. Okay, let's do it everywhere. Just let's keep little place for the sun over here. Okay, and rest of the place, how many ever we want, we can do. Alright, so here I go. It's a small R and that's a big R. Okay, that's it. Come on, let's do some more. You know what are these birds I'm making, right? They are the quails. I think this much is enough, right? Isn't it? Yes.
Okay. Now let's do the sun. For the sun, I'm going to take a piece of yellow paper. I'm going to make a circle and cut it out. And then I'm going to cut strips, thin strips, okay, for the rays of the sun. All right. So here it is. All right. Now I'm ready with my sun circle and I'm ready with the rays too. So I'm just going to apply glue and stick. Okay. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4 for the beginning. Let's do it that way. Now we are going to add some more thing to our wilderness, that is cactus. We are going to make cactus with different shades of green. Alright, but before we start making cactus, let me put this aside. I've taken this shade of green. Now let's first draw a long shape. Okay, then we will give it another long shape and little up another long shape. I don't know what the shape is called. And now let's cut it. Okay, so here I have 4 different colors of cactus. Now what we're going to do is, the very important thing that the cactus have is thorns. So I've taken here my black steddler and we just have to make anyhow pokey lines. Can you see them? Can you see them? Yeah? Okay. Just pokey lines anyhow, just to make them anyhow, anywhere. Alright. Okay, let me just finish it and I'll show you. So, this is how it should look. Alright. So now let me do these thorns on all of them. Right, I've done to all the 4 cactus. Now let's keep it aside. Now the next thing I'm going to teach you is the bird, the quail. Alright, so for that we're going to need a black paper, any shade of grey, any shade of brown. Alright, so let me get the papers and come back. I'm going to make 2 birds. So I'm going to make one bird of this brown, one bird of this grey, and their wings, both of their wings I'm going to make with darker brown, and their head with the black. Head, legs and beak and the crest, all with the black. Alright, let's get started. So first of all, what I want you to do is fold your paper. Alright, then this is very simple. Just make a nice semicircle. Anything. That's it. Take the paper for the wings. Fold it again. Fold this one too. Okay. Let's make one more semicircle. Now this time we are going to make a semicircle which is a little smaller. See? This is the body. So I have taken this size for the wing. Okay, now this is my folded end, so I'm going to keep the paper like this and I'm going to make the semicircle this way. Okay, all right, and with the same paper we're going to make the tail. So for the tail we're just going to cut that's it, just a rectangle. Alright, and then for the face, one more semicircle, but this is going to be really really small. Okay, this one is going to be really small because we're going to have it only this much part. Okay, so again on the fold let's make a C. That's it. Now let's cut everything. I'll quickly cut it. I'm done with the cutting. So because I kept it on the fold, okay? It will give me like this, two parts. Let it be like this. But this one, I'm going to cut in the middle. Okay, so I get two equal parts. And even for the face, I'm going to cut in the middle. Alright. Now, it's time for glue. So this is how it will look when it sticks. Now I'm going to do the other side also. Now see to it that now have we left more space here and little space here. Same way when we turn, we have to keep little space here and more space here. Okay? Don't forget that. Okay, children. Let me check. Yes, less space here. Yeah. That way. Okay. Now let's stick the face. That is the head. Okay. Now it's gonna go like this. Right? It's gonna go like this. Okay. Let's do the other side also. My dog is having a dream. He's making weird noises. Alright, so that becomes the head of the bird. Okay, now what we have to do? Yes, I have told you about the tail, right? I did not cut the tail. See this. I'll quickly cut the tail. So, when you cut this, see, again it is on the fold, right? What you do is, give a V cut. Okay, like this. So it will look like this. Alright. Okay, now let's put glue on this end. Not the V cut end, okay? This end. And let's stick it in between. Okay, see? Like this. Let's stick it inside the fold. Okay? That's it. Now, let's draw. Now we have one beak, two legs and one crest to draw. Okay, so let's quickly draw the crest. Can you? Okay, this is the crest. All right then this will be the beak. Okay, and we are going to draw, we'll give a fold and we will draw legs. So we will automatically get two legs. Okay. Okay, that's it. Now let me quickly cut it. Okay, children, so leg, a crest and a beak. Let me quickly cut it. So now I'm done cutting with the crest, the legs and the beak. Okay, now let's quickly stick it. Okay, is it same? No, I messed up. Now is it same? Yes. Okay, that looks okay. Now let's stick the beak. Let's put it here in the middle like this. Okay. Right? And the crest. Now if you want your bird facing this side, put the crest behind, okay? Whichever side you want your bird. If this is the front, then put the crest behind. If this is going to be your front, then put the crest behind, okay? So I think this should be my front, so I'll put the crest here. Like this. Ooh, that's my quail. And the only thing remaining, the eyes. So I'm going to cut two white papers and make a black ball inside just with a pen or a steadler. Alright. And then stick it. I have made the eyes. Let's stick them. You know, I have made one mistake. And my trusty help has told me that the crest doesn't face this side. It should face the other side. Alright. So, thank you, my daughter. Okay. Here is my first eye. Here is my second eye. Okay. Woo! My quail is done. And you know the funny part of it? It can even stand. Can you see that it's standing? Yes. Yes. Okay. Alright, let's make one more. With the same, everything same, but only the body will be of this color. Alright, now our cactus needs to stand, which is not happening right now. So, I'm going to make a stand for it. So, I've cut this white strips of the same hard paper, okay, which I've used for the diorama. Alright, we just bend two ends of it and we glue them. Very simple, huh? We glue them. That's it. And just don't let it be pointy. Just press it a little bit. That's it. Done. And now this side which we had glued, let's put glue on the outer side also. And we are just going to put our cactus on it. But see to it that when you stick it, you stick it with the same level, okay? Don't stick the cactus too low. Alright, it has to be the same level. Voila! Now our cactus stands. I'll show you one more. Very easy. Let's just bend two ends. Okay? And let's just glue them. Like this. Let's just press this side. Oh, press this side so that it doesn't become into a triangle. Okay, let's glue the outer side of it and stick our cactus on it. Done. Okay, level it. Okay, level it. And oops, done. So our cactus, all four of them are ready to go on the diorama with the birds. Yes. All right, now it's time to get our diorama. So here is our diorama. Now it's time to stick it. So for sticking, what do we do? This part which we have kept empty, we're going to put glue all over it. Okay, let's do that first. And then we are just going to flip it here. Okay, easy, right? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Just flip it here and stick it. So this is what it will look like once it is done. All right, so here it is. This is how it looks. Okay. I am so sorry, it is not fitting in the view, but this is how it is. Okay, alright. Okay, so now let us quickly stick the cactus. Birds we don't need to stick because they are going to stand. Alright, so for this cactus, what we are going to do is, we are just going to glue the bottom part. Glue this much. Done. Okay, let's just glue the bottom part. Be generous on the glue this time. Let's put it here. I mean, you can put it anywhere you want to. Alright. Then we can just make our birds stand there. Anywhere. Anywhere you want. Like, I can put this bird here. I can put this bird here. Facing anywhere, doesn't matter. Okay. Now, what we have to do is manna. Manna, which tasted like honey. It was like white wafers, which tasted like honey. So what I'm doing is I have folded a tissue paper. I'm just going to make circle on it. Okay, and I'm going to cut that. That's it. Done. See, manna is ready. So you can stick it anywhere you want to. Right? Just stick it anywhere you want to. Alright, one more thing I want to tell you is keep this part empty because we have to write something over there. Okay? So let's just keep that part empty. Alright, children? Yes, if you want some more manna, cut some more tissue paper and just stick it. Alright? Okay, now I'll tell you what you're going to stick here. So take the white paper strip and I'll tell you what to write on it. I want you all to take a blank white paper, alright? And you have to write on it, God provides food for the Israelites in the desert. Alright? Now let's write it with... I'm going to write it with a blue marker. God provides food for the Israelites in the desert. Okay, now whatever the pencil lines, you can just erase it. Alright, and after erasing we will stick it, we'll try to find the center and we are going to stick it here. Okay, children? Alright, I've sticked it and we are done. So all my children, I really would like to see this diorama done by you. Okay, please make it.
Thank you so much for joining us today. If you liked our video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.